Hi friends, today let's see how to configure journals in Odoo 15. So an accounting journal, it is a record of transaction exchanges requested by date, and these transactions are recorded in the name of journal entries. So you can view all the journal entries in your accounting by clicking on this menu, and each journal entry shows the account names and their credits and debit values. And in Odoo, we can create different types of journals. So we already have sales, purchase, bank and cash, then miscellaneous journals. So each journals have its own rules. So let's configure journal by coming under configuration. Here you can find a menu journals. So these are the pre-configured journals in Odoo, and here you can click on create button in order to create a new journal. So here we have a journal customer invoices, and you can view the type of the journal. Like here it is set as sales. So we have different types like purchase, cash, bank, miscellaneous. So sales journal, it is used to send customer invoices, and purchase journal, it is used to post received vendor bills. Then cash type journal is used to track daily cash transactions as well as the received customer payments. Then bank is used for posting your bank statements, then track customer or vendor payments and all other transactions recorded by your associated bank account. And then we have miscellaneous type, journal type. It is used for anything that doesn't fit into the above types. So you can see here, we have different tabs here. Here you can find some details related to journal entries. Then we have advanced settings for your journal. So depending upon the type you have chosen here, you can find different options. Like here for sales, you can set the accounting information, including the default income account, then the dedicated credit note sequence. So we can enable this checkbox in order to share the same sequence for invoice and credit notes made from this journal. Then the journal entries from this journal can use a shortcode provided here. So here already IMV is given as a shortcode. Then for this journal, you can use a specific currency. You can set a specific currency. So entries will be created in this currency. Then here, there is an advanced settings. This includes a control access. You can control access of journal by allowing some account types and accounts. So you can select it from here. And you can also keep this empty for no control. Then we can log posted entries with hash. Then you can enable electronic invoicing for journals. And here you can configure email servers. And here you can add the details related to payment communication, like communication type. So it can be based on invoice, based on customer, or you can make it open. So you can see based on invoice is set as a default communication type. So this will appear on the customer invoice once it is validated. So the customers can refer to that invoice when making the payment. And you can use a communication standard. So it is set as Odoo. Then there is an option in order to follow the customer payments. Like if you choose this journal, and if you create an invoice using this journal, and when the due date is reached, then automatically an activity can be scheduled. So that activity you have to choose from here. That is which activity need to be scheduled. Like if you want to call, make a call with the customer when the due date is reached, here you can set that and set the activity user and add activity summary. So automatically this call will be scheduled on invoice due date. Then next we have type purchase. So according to that, here you can find the change. like the accounting information contains default expense account. So you can record expenses on default expense account. Then credit note sequence can be given, short code, currency, and some advanced settings related to the purchase journal, like the control access, then email configuration. And here we can find type cash and bank. So in the case of cash and bank, you can find extra two tabs here. Like here we can add incoming payment details and outgoing payment details. So here we can add the payment lines, like payment method and name. And here under accounting information, there you can add the bank account and the suspense account. So bank transactions will be posted on this suspense account until the final reconciliation, and then currency, short code, and bank account details like account number and bank feeds. And you can define how bank statements need to be registered. You can set as undefined, or you can import CSV, OFX, or CMT file, or you can use automated bank synchronization to register the bank statements. Then here we have advanced settings, where we can add the control access. Then next we have miscellaneous journal. There also you can set control access and some accounting information, including currency and short code. So these are the types available. Now let's check the case of a customer invoice journal with type sales. So after configuring the journal, you can save transaction. So let me create an invoice. So here you can choose a customer, then you can find the delivery address, can provide the payment reference, and you can choose the invoice date. And here you can set the due date. Or you can choose a payment term from here. And here you can choose a journal and currency for this invoice. So I'm choosing customer invoices with journal type sales. And if you have any doubts, just check inside this form and you can make further changes. Now let me add some products to order line, invoice line. And now let me confirm this invoice. So invoice is generated and it is confirmed. Now, if the customer makes the payment, we can click on this register payment to register the payment by choosing the journal, bank of cash journal, recipient bank account. Then the amount can be viewed with the currency, payment date and memo. So here you can see below under the history that a call was scheduled with the customer yesterday. This is because here you can find the due date is yesterday, that is invoice due date. And inside our journal, we have planned an activity call when the due date is reached. So this is used to follow the customer on invoice payment. So we can make a call with the customer and remind him about the invoice payment. So if it is done, you can mark as done. And here you can find a tab where journal items are shown. This includes all the accounts that are affected. So here we can find the income account, product sales. You can find a 120 credit. Then we have a tax account, 18 credited. Then account receivable, there you can find the debit 138, then the output account, then expense account. So this is because our accounting mode is Anglo-Saxon, and in the case of Anglo-Saxon accounting, the cost of goods is only recorded, as an expense when this good is invoiced to a final customer. So if you have created a purchase order and if you have confirmed it and created a bill, expense account won't be affected. It will only be affected after this good is invoiced to a customer. And for this product, cable management box, if you check the product category, you can see the inventory valuation is automated. So accounting entries will be generated automatically and it will be posted. So you can see here under accounting, the journals. So here we can check our sales journal and you can view the journal entries related to this invoice. So you can find all the accounts affected, the debit, credit, amount and currency. Then you can also create an entry manually. Here you can click on the journal entries and create a new entry. You can provide a reference and accounting date. Then you can choose journal type from here, currency, and here you can add the accounts, partner, then the currency and whether it is a debit or credit. So this way here you can add the journal items and you can post those items from here. And you can also set a fiscal position for the journal entry. And if you want to post an entry automatically, that can be enabled from here. So now we can save this and post the entry. So here you can find an entry is created. Now let's open our customer invoice and register the payment. So I'm choosing the journal as bank. And you can see now the status in payment because the reconciliation is not done. So it will be moved to paid only when it is reconciled. That is, invoice is reconciled with the bank statement. So now when you open bank and cash journal, here you can see there is a credit in account receivable and there is a debit on outstanding receipts, not the bank account. So this is because before reconciliation, the payments will be posted on outstanding accounts. So in the case of invoices, it will be outstanding receipt. And in the case of vendor payments, it will be outstanding payments. So only after reconciliation, it will be posted on bank or cash account. So let's create a bank statement. Can choose a journal, then the date, and here you can add the transaction line. Can choose a partner and the amount. Now we can post this. So before posting, make sure that you have changed the ending balance. Then after posting, reconcile. So here you can see automatically that invoice is matched with the amount that we have given inside the statement. And now let us click on validate. Now if you open bank and cash journal, you can see that is posted on bank account. That is, there is a credit on account receivable and debit on bank account. So reconciliation is done. So that's how we configure journal in Order 50. And if you have any queries related to this video, you can add in the comment section. And if you have any queries related to this video, you can add in the comment box. And if you're looking for any customization or implementation in your business, drop a request to odwardcybrosis.com.